गुड इवनिंग, आई एम डॉक्टर मैथ्यू एंड आई एम ऑल्सो इन्वॉल्व विद creation.com विच इज़ पार्ट ऑफ क्रिएशन मिनिस्ट्रीज इंटरनेशनल. बींग अ मेडिकल डॉक्टर आई केम हियर बिकॉज आई एम एज वेरी मच इंटरेस्टेड इन पीस एंड एज यू मैंशनड पीस इज बोथ इंटरनल एंड एक्सटर्नल. नाउ पर्सनली वेन आई एंड मिलियंस ऑफ अदर पीपल हैव फाउंड आफ्टर बींग कन्विक्टेड ऑफ आवर सिन एंड रिपेंटिंग ऑफ इट that and having accepted and believed that Jesus Christ, the sinless man, paid the full price for my sins. He took my shame and guilt on the cross and died for me, because of which I have peace. And that peace is something which passes understanding. I want to know, would you like to take away that peace which I have, which is a peace which passes understanding? And can you answer that? Thank you.
Brother asked a very good question. He is Dr. Mathew. He's got a website and organization called Creation. He said that he found peace. He came here to attain peace. He said he got peace in Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, who died for his sins on the cross. He died for his sins on the cross. So he's asking me that, would I like to take away your peace? Brother, I would never like to take away your peace. I would like to take away your false peace and make you get the true peace. I love Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. I respect him and I revere him. I want to know that, do you also love Jesus Christ or not? I am asking you.
Yes.
Do you agree?
Yeah.
Do you believe that Jesus is God?
Yes.
Yes, brother. Now, either you get true peace or I will come to your peace.
Yes.
Correct? If yours is true peace, I will leave my peace and I will join you.
Yes.
Now you told me Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is God. I challenge you to point out a single verse in the Bible, a single unequivocal verse from the Bible, a single unambiguous verse in which Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, himself says that I am God, or where he says worship me and I am ready to accept Christianity. You said Jesus is God. As far as Muslims are concerned, Islam is the only non-Christian faith which makes it an article of faith to believe in Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. No Muslim is a Muslim if he does not believe in Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. We believe that he was one of the mightiest messengers of Almighty God. We believe that he was the Messiah, translated Christ. We believe that he was born miraculously without any male intervention, which many modern day Christians do not believe. We believe that he gave life to the dead with God's permission. We believe he healed those born blind and lepers with God's permission. The Muslims, the Christians, they are going together. But the parting of ways is, as you said, that most of the Christians, they believe that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, claim divinity. There is not a single unequivocal statement in the complete Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, himself says that I am God, or where he says worship me. If you can point out, I am ready to accept Christianity. So if he has not said that, why do you believe he is God? And where did Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, say that he died on the cross for your sins? That is the teaching of Paul. Are you following Paul or are you following Jesus Christ, peace be upon him? Nowhere in the Bible. So my question is, when Jesus Christ never said he was God, if you love him, you have to respect him. He said, when he was asked, which is the first of the commandments? It's mentioned in the Gospel of Mark, chapter number 12, verse number 29. He said, Shema Israelo adnan haidman daikhad. Hear, O Israel, the God, our Lord, is one God. He repeated verbatim what was said by Moses earlier. Peace be upon him. So what I am asking you, if you know the teachings of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, if you say Christian is a person who follows the teachings of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, it is mentioned in the book of Ephesians, chapter number 5, verse number 18, that do not be drunk with wine. It's mentioned in the book of Proverbs, chapter number 20, verse number 1, that wine is a mocker. Whoever deceives has it. We Muslims, we don't have alcohol, but many of the Christians have alcohol. Furthermore, we Muslims don't have pork. It's mentioned in the Bible, in the book of Leviticus, chapter number 11, verse number 7 and 8, in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 14, verse number 8, in the book of Isaiah, chapter number 65, verse number 2 to 5, that you should not have pork. We Muslims don't have pork, but Christians have pork, most of them. Furthermore, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he was circumcised on the 8th day, according to Gospel of Luke, chapter number 2, verse number 21. We Muslims are circumcised, most of the Christians are not. If Christian means a person who follows the teachings of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, I'm proud to say we Muslims are more Christian than the Christian themselves. So where do you follow the teachings of Jesus Christ and you say that you worship him? So brother, point out a single verse in the Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said unequivocally that I am God or worship me.
Dr. Zakir Naik.
Yes, brother.
My question was on peace, and I have that peace. I don't have to memorize memory verses to prove or disagree with you. What brother, I am sharing is that the peace which I have because of the belief, because we are all sinners and we need a sacrifice to pay for our sins. It is not by our works that we are saved.
Correct.
But by believing in faith that Jesus Christ has paid the price for my sins.
Fine. So you agree that Jesus Christ has paid for the sins of all humanity? Do you agree with that?
Yes.
Okay.
All who believe in him.
Okay, fine. So suppose a Christian comes like you who believes in Jesus Christ and he rapes your wife. Will he go to heaven or hell?
Pardon?
If a Christian comes and rapes your wife, he believes Jesus Christ died for his sins. So whatever sin he does, it is paid for it. So if Jesus Christ had died for his sin, it will give permission for all the Christians to rape the woman.
Never.
Why never? You said, brother, you told your work will not take you to heaven. It is your belief. So if you believe Jesus Christ died for your sin, and if you commit rape, if you rob, if you oppress other people, will you go to heaven?
He is not a Christian. If he does that, simple.
But he believes in Jesus Christ. There are many Christians who I know. That means it's a wrong belief. Correct.
In the Bible also it is written that even the devils believe in Jesus Christ. But they don't follow him.
Correct. They don't. Do you follow Jesus Christ? Peace be upon him. Are you circumcised?
Yes, sir.
Are you circumcised?
No, I am not circumcised.
So why don't you follow Jesus Christ, peace be upon him? Jesus Christ was circumcised on the 8th day. You're a doctor, correct?
Yes.
You know that circumcision is beneficial medically.
So that was not in my hands. It was in my parents' hands.
So you can do it now also, no problem.
Sure.
If you want, I'll help you. Point number one. Point number two. Do you have pork, brother?
No.
You don't have pork. Why?
It's mentioned in the Old Testament.
Correct.
And God has mentioned it.
Do you have intoxicant? Do you have alcohol?
No.
Fine. Do you believe Jesus is God?
Jesus Christ is God, came on the earth as a human being.
Where it is mentioned? Which verse of the Bible? Tell me.
Which verse of the Bible?
Yeah, which verse of the Bible? Which verse of the Bible where Jesus Christ himself says he's God? Suppose someone tells you are God. Will you believe you are God? Someone says I am God. Will I believe? Point to be noted is that Jesus Christ never claimed divinity. In fact, if you go to the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 19, verse number 16 and 17, there's a person who comes to Jesus Christ and says, good master, what good things should I do so that I enter eternal life? So Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says, why thou callest me good? Leave aside God. Why thou callest me good? There's only one good, and that is a God in heaven. And if you want to enter eternal life, you keep the commandments. He never said that if you want to go to paradise, you believe I'm God. He never said that you believe that I died on the cross for your sins. He said, if you want to go to paradise, you keep the commandments. And the commandments are what? You should not rob. You should not have alcohol. You should not covet your neighbor's wife. Commandments, the deeds. The deeds will take you to paradise. Jesus Christ never said he was God. So why are you saying that Jesus is God, peace be upon him? You are not following his teachings also.
I didn't say that Jesus Christ is God for this argument. I just said that I have the peace in my heart. And that peace I want to share.
Brother, there are many people, you know, there's a Satan worshipping cult. Do you know that?
Are
you
aware? Satan worshipping cult.
Correct. So they get peace by worshipping Satan. But that is false peace. Therefore, I want to take you out from false peace and make you enter true peace. What you're saying is peace is actually not peace. You are worshipping a false God. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, never said he was God. So because they're worshipping a false God and you're in the false peace, like people worship Satans and yet they think that they're on the right track, I want to get you out of the false peace and get you into true peace. Because I consider myself to be a true Christian. If Christian means a person who follows the teachings of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, then I'm more Christian than the Christian themselves. Do you know Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said in the Gospel of John, chapter number 16, verse number 12 to 14, I have many things to say unto you, but ye cannot bear them now. For he, when the Spirit of truth shall come, he shall guide you unto all truth. He shall show you things to come. He shall glorify me. Now, which man, which prophet after Jesus has ever glorified Isa alayhi salam? Jesus Christ. It is Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So this prophecy of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is mentioned in your Bible. There are several quotations. I am asking you, why don't you follow the instruction of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him? And why don't you follow Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him? What kind of a Christian are you?
Do you mean to say that I don't follow the teachings of Christians?
Not at all. I'm giving you quotations with reference. You go back home and check the Bible with references. You are not a true Christian. I am a true Christian.
It's easy to judge, brother.
Easy, very easy. I'm giving you with quotation. What you are saying, you have not given a single quotation. I challenge your doctors of divinity. Doctors of divinity of Christendom. Anyone, get your doctors of divinity. If you say you don't have the knowledge, get your doctors of divinity. Who's the best in the world? And let us have a dialogue.
Sure.
But the person should be powerful, not just a roadside person, a person who can attract people, a person who has a following. You get the best one that you have in India, best one that you have in the world, and we'll have a dialogue.
Yes,
and you can ask him, and you ask him all the questions I've asked, that where is it mentioned in the Bible? Any unequivocal statement where Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, himself says that I am God, or where he says worship me. I, Dr. Zakir Naik, I am immediately accepting. If you can point out from any version of the Bible, any unequivocal statement, any unambiguous statement where Jesus Christ, peace be upon himself, says that I am God or worship me, I am ready to accept him to be God. But there's no statement. So what you are doing is you are not following the teachings of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. It is the teachings of the church, not of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. So therefore I request you, brother, that please leave the false peace and enter into true peace. The true peace is submitting your will to God. God who created Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. Not a false God. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was a messenger of God, but he was not God. Hope that answers the question.
لا تظنوا أني جئت لأنقض الناموس أو الأنبياء، ما جئت لأنقض بل لأكمله. فإن الحق أقول لكم، إلى أن تزول السماء والأرض لا يزول حرف واحد أو نقطة واحدة من الناموس حتى يكون الكل. فمن نقض إحدى هذه الوصايا الصغرى وعلم الناس هكذا يدعى أصغر في ملكوت السماوات، وأما من عمل وعلم فهذا يدعى عظيما في ملكوت السماوات.
جليل على أم المجادل في الكلام رأيت الله في ذا الكون ربا جميع الكائنات
صلى سبسكرايب لكل شخص
after him, as we inspired Abraham and Ishmael and Isaac and Jacob and the tribes, and Jesus and Job and Jonah and Aaron and Solomon, and as we imparted unto David the Psalms. The verse we've just heard is from chapter 4 of the Quran. In the verse, God is affirming to humanity that Muhammad is indeed the recipient of a divine guidance, just as Noah, Abraham, and the rest of the prophets. However, some Christians and Jews today don't believe that Muhammad was a prophet and the covenant that God made with Abraham. And since the Quran is not their book of authority, in this video I'm going to show you that the book you're holding in your hands contains the name of the seal of prophethood, the Prophet Muhammad. As known, the Old Testament was preserved in the Hebrew language. In the fifth chapter of the Shir HaShirim, which is one of the five Megillic or sacred scrolls that are part of the Hebrew Bible, or for short the Song of Solomon, as Christians know it today. That chapter is discussing someone. Jews will say it is discussing Solomon, while Christians will say it is discussing Jesus. Considering this is the Songs of Solomon, it would seem logical that it is discussing Solomon. The verses describing this mystery man have the narrator's speech conjugated in the feminine, meaning it is a woman who is describing this man. So it is possible that it is one of Solomon's wives discussing her husband Solomon. However, Christians assert that Jesus is being discussed, and that the chapter is describing a man who was not yet alive at that point. A prophecy. In reading the English translation of Song of Songs 5:16, it finishes the description by saying, "He is altogether lovely," but what most people don't know is that the name of that man was given in the original Megillat. Here is verse 16, and how it is written in ancient Hebrew, before introducing the vowels, in the 8th century. From the Hebrew Bible, on scripturetext.com. Here is the word in question. This word is made of four letters.
Mem, Het, Mem, Dalet.
Now when reading the word as it is written in its original form, with no vowels, it can be read as Muhammad, which is the name of the Muslim prophet, or as Mamad with no E after the H. According to Ben Yehuda's Hebrew-English Dictionary, it is correctly pronounced as Muhammad, not Mamad. So how we're going to know for sure if it's pronounced as Muhammad, the Muslim prophet, or as Mamad, a random Hebrew word? The only way is to give the verse to a rabbi and say to him, "Please read. Here is the Song of Songs 5:16. and how it is read by a rabbi from a Hebrew Jewish site. Please notice, the im in Hebrew is a plural of respect.
חיקו ממתקים וכולו מעמדים, זה דודי וזה רעי בנות ירושלים. חיקו ממתקים וכולו מעמדים, זה דודי וזה רעי בנות ירושלים.
لكل شخص ما بعرف يشترك بالقناة تحت الفيديو مباشرة بإمكانك تحضر فيديو كيفية الاشتراك بالقناة وشكرا لكم ونشوفكم في فيديوهات الجاي وباي باي.